Good morning, everyone in the room and all of you who are watching us online. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Theodora. I'm based at the MOLA Northampton office, and I decided to put together this presentation because it's marking the 1 year in my new role as head of archives for MOLA. Clearly, I have discussed this with a number of archives teams in the last 2 decades. But for this presentation today, my thanks go to my colleagues in the London team, Anna Rivoli, Jan Hartung, Pippa Ketley, Julia Lazeri, and the Northampton team, Jen Whitby and Fionn Rogers. The memes that you are going to see, and I hope you enjoy them, are personally selected by Jen. So. Okay, I decided to play a little bit here with the definition of the word legacy, mainly highlighting the particular events and actions that took place in the past. And as we stand being tasked of dealing with a legacy project, most of the archives staff associate this word with pain, or the equivalent adjectives. The reason being, these archives, there are 3 levels here. They are very important and quite a lot. They have not been published for various reasons. I do hope there are only archives left from the 90s in most of the registered archaeological organizations and not before that time. But perhaps we should have another survey looking at this. And in a lot of cases, because they involve open area excavations that were taking place for a number of years or quarry projects, they are multi-faced and complicated. The work has been in progress for many years and by many internal colleagues, some of whom or most of have left the units, which is a big problem. And clearly, we have external stakeholders who know about the project, museum curators and even consultants, and they need to be kept in the loop. So they are not in a depositable state, and we clearly need to carry on the preparation work in order to make them depositable. And for that particular reason, I think the first thing to do is to make an assessment of who can help with XYZ project in the organization. And here is how some of us feel about these archives, hence the title of this presentation. Some realistic tips here are that they have changed hands and locations in the office. The same and the worst is the finds boxes have changed storage locations through the years. People have started looking and compiling indexes both for the documentary and the finds archives, but in most cases they have not fully completed them. And the project team members have changed for all levels, as you can see. Accession numbers might have been issued in good time, but may not. So we need to review them with the curator or the HCR, or for the later phases, which is true for a number of them, we really need to have new ones issued. Worst of all, transfer of title, which most probably might not have been completed still, which clearly is a big issue. And it might take over a year, as I have experienced in some cases, to be sorted. So I came up with this motto while writing this presentation, industrially specific, because of the level and the scale of the tasks and the boxes involved. I know the presentation is thinking outside the box, but clearly here we have a lot of boxes to deal with. It's the opposite here. And we tried to write a few recommendations because obviously the aim of this presentation is to share experiences, get you talking about the same subject. but mostly to also engage the early careers colleagues who would like to have an archives orientation, shall we say. So the designer of the PowerPoint gave me this lovely table here, think time budget. I think it's quite good how it turned out here, because obviously the focus here is the budget after so many years. In some cases, some of the early career colleagues most probably are the same age group with these archives. And if we look at this, clearly in some cases we are dealing with budget zero. The creative possibilities we are mentioning here, obviously, they are very limited, and we are talking about secondments from students, perhaps some collaborations with universities, work experience, and potentially people from the excavation teams, our colleagues, who would like to have a training, and we can swap team members. I think the best thing to do here is to subgroup the tasks, and I would strongly recommend to start with the ones that will take the longest, and usually this means take the focus on the finds archives, and get some easy wins. For example, quickly type handwritten indexes. That's a good start. But also, in order to do this, the archives team needs quite a lot of support from other colleagues. So I think it's best to treat it as a new project with the colleagues that can help you and can set up the whole legacy project as a new project, basically. And starting to put all this together, perhaps this is how most of us feel, but stage two means collecting and assessing. And clearly the priorities on finances and what we can do and how we can deliver it internally first. The finds boxes checks, I think they need to take presence and priority in this, and possibly also one action that can help with the deposition costs and making the archive more usable for the future, future-proofing it, is deselection strategy. And okay, in some cases within the county and our colleagues from the specialist groups, we can work together because we've got these long relationships. Security copies, options and costs need to be on the table from day one. And also because in a lot of cases, younger colleagues will come across black and white and color slides, which in some cases they haven't even seen before. the filing is a big issue, and the digital access options and costs again. Project manager who clearly didn't talk to archives, that's how it feels, and big surprises there. But clearly a summary of what I have just been demonstrating here, call the meetings internally and make sure that we've got a very accurate timetable where we can close down tasks with the archives team first, and make sure we transfer the whole archive into a new location, because that will massively help with labeling preparation and final checks before transfer to the repository. Last but not least, meetings with the curator and starting the process of physical transfer paperwork. And right now, an issue of which guidelines version the fees are going to match with. But there are some positives here, because we've learned lessons from this process, and most of the people and most of the feedback that I had is that the context record forms especially were far more informative, and the excavation team had more part to play in the period before the report. But the file name and file saving issue is one that follows archaeologists all around. This has not changed much, unfortunately. And certain communication issues between team members or excavation, post-ex and archives. One positive thing on the paper side is that there is more preservation awareness of the elements as we are hitting like from 2000 onwards. This is everything for us. Question time for later. Thank you all.